What's up guys, welcome back to the channel, and today I'm going to go over some very quick things, some little things you want to know about in Naxxramas to instantly increase your parses. In the background while I do this intro is going to be my actual footage from today's stream as I was going to try to pump on Saffron where I was at 15k DPS or 1.5k DPS and then my internet just cut out. But basically, what I want to go over today is everything I've learned from basically dissecting the logs, where if you have a good or clean run, especially on any of these fights specifically, you can focus on doing little different things that will increase your parse. This is mostly for parses. It will help for the most part, but there are some fights where it's actually not really helpful for you to go for some of these little cheesy things. And that's things like cheese or cleave, like we know already, pretty much like bug trio. But again, with that being said, let's hop right into the video. Okay, so first off, I want to go through quite a few things. I'm not going to go in any particular order, but the gear from the actual invasions, the bracers or the undead slaying set, which gives you 2% increased damage to undead. Now, this is abyss for mages or actually just insane for cloth, but it's actually pretty incredible as it's being found out for almost every other DPS class on specific fights, which can be potentially Lotheb, but absolutely Thaddeus. So Thaddeus, where you're already getting an increase to your damage, this actually scales on top of that. So this is actually incredible for Thaddeus. And this is something I did not discover myself. Ganker1 from Salad Bakers told me about this. So this is absolutely something you should be farming right now because you only pretty much have this week to get this set. Now, with that being said, let's just move on to any different fight. And so Kel'Thuzad, one thing I want to note for everyone is that none of the damage on any of the adds in phase one counts towards your log. Let me actually move my face itself. There we go. None of the damage from phase one counts towards your log. So all of your damage is purely on the boss itself. Although you can get a little bit of cleave damage on your friends when they get mind controlled, that's cheesy and kind of unfortunate. So you're not going to be aiming to do that, but none of the damage comes from any of the adds. Moving on from that, Noth the Plaguebringer is actually a fight where the damage to the adds does count. So he summons those plague warriors which come to the middle of the room, and the world's top parse on this is actually a rogue, not a warrior. It's bulky from my server actually. And so if you want to increase your DPS on this fight, you really want to focus on using your cleave and big CDs when the adds come out, as you can see right here. So a ton of damage can happen right here during cleave phases. This also means using a cheesy sapper charge to increase your DPS. My Exena, there's a couple things you can really do. One thing, really RNG, is hope that you don't get web wrapped all the way in the back of the room. That's just unfortunate. Two, one thing to note is that the cleave damage on the adds does count. So a big sapper charge can do a ton of damage towards your parse. So if you get a bunch of crits on your sapper charge, which this one hit 10 targets and had zero crits, that will do a ton of damage. You can get about 10k extra damage on your actual parse in this fight. Another thing, as a rogue or as a paladin or anyone really, if you're using Petri Flask, but you can batch the actual stun on this boss. You can batch the stun where you can vanish batch it and you don't get stunned like the rest of the raid does. You could use a Petri, but it's just really easy to vanish batch it. It's pretty much on timer with the DBM timer. Moving past my Exena, staying in the Spider Quarter, Grand Widow Feralina. Spider Wing is amazing for cleaving, but Feralina, this is kind of a harder one to actually pull off because the cleave damage does completely count towards your log, but only if you're attacking the followers. So as you can see here, the Naxxramas followers take 100% cleave damage towards your parse. So any of the damage on the followers goes towards the log. Now, most skills are going to pull the followers away so that they can safely mind control them. It doesn't really matter though, because you don't need to mind control all of them on any of these fights, especially on a quicker fight of Grand Widow Feralina. So if your guild allows it, get some huge damage out, or even just if your guild doesn't allow for you guys to get any cleave out, I would then go for an early sapper charge, a little bit of cleave damage really early, and just to increase your overall damage. It's just kind of cheesing, but there are all of the other adds here. None of them count whatsoever towards your log. Past that, again in the spider wing, we're just going backwards in the spider wing, is Anub Rakan. So Anub Rakan, this is another fight where you are absolutely looking to cleave. Most of your damage is going to be cleave. As you can see, this is the world's number one parse on this fight, almost 3000 DPS, and a ton of damage is cleave. Almost 30k damage is from cleave itself and whirlwind. So over 30k damage altogether is from cleave and whirlwind. So a ton of your damage is cleave. Stack the adds on the boss itself. The only fear really is if the boss gets passed into his like little insect swarm or locust swarm phase, it's gonna scuff you quite a bit because you're not actually on top of the boss DPSing. You are fighting adds, which does help because those go towards your parse, but it's not really the same. Try to just focus the boss itself, cleave the adds down really quickly, and you will do incredible here. Moving on to Hygin. Hygin, the only thing you really need to focus on is killing him before he does the dance, or else this kind of scuffs you overall. So as you can look at the kill times here, on any of the top parses, it's gonna be around 1 minute. So you want to kill this boss before he does the dance, or else you're pretty much screwed. Patchwork. Patchwork is the exact situation that every sim is based off of, right? It's basically a target dummy, standing still, and there's nothing to fear, nothing to worry about. If you start to get high on threat, and this can only happen early on, make sure you use a lip just to be safe, because if Patrick then goes and hateful strikes someone else because you are in a lip situation, or if you run into the poison pool and drop your health pool in half, then they will get increased threat from receiving the hateful strike. So Patrick is literally the epitome of Tengen's Bank. That's basically the ideal situation for using every cooldown. Saffron. On Saf, a big thing for especially rogues is that you can attack the boss while it's in his actual like flying phase. So during the flying phase, you can still sit there and attack the boss. As you can see on my screen, I was still backstabbing the boss while it was flying. You don't need to go run into position until like the fourth or even just the fifth bomb goes out or ice block goes out. Rogues can vanish the bomb itself. Everyone else could Petri flask the bomb until Petri's might potentially get pulled from Warcraft logs. So for now, DPS as much as you can. Special attacks still hit the boss. Your normal melee attacks don't. If you are a mage or anything else, you can still hit the boss. Just if you want to do really well on this boss, basically just make sure that you're still attacking it. A faster kill is usually very helpful here because you have to use a lot less frost resistance, and that also entices you to have world buffs, so you might have to leave and come back with world buffs. Either way, if you want to have an incredible parse here, which I was trying to go for one of the 100 parses here tonight, and at 1500 DPS just getting DC'd, even though it's decently early, that is just unfortunate. Four horsemen. Now, for Four Horsemen, the name of the game is Cleave. As you can see, progress is extremely high on a lot of these logs, and we're gonna look at something that matters massively. Look at all of the bosses they damage. So in a lot of kills right now, most of the melee are not attacking all four bosses, mainly because we mostly won't go attack Zaliak. But if you look at Tetsu's log, he's done almost 20k damage, 19k damage to Zaliak. Most of the damage is, of course, on Morgraine and Thane, and I'm actually going to pull up a clip here where they actually just went in and cleaved down both of the initial bosses before moving on to any of the rest. So here's a clip from Tetsu's stream where they actually hard focus down all the bosses. Right as you pull initially, you do want to get a fat sapper charge off because then you will hit all four of them for just some little cheesy damage. That was something we were already seeing, but this is a couple weeks in, 2 weeks in, and we are already seeing a guild use Recklessness, Death Wish, and just blow up two of the bosses at the exact same time. The first two bosses die instantly for the most part, so they are using everything they can to burn these down. This is going to be huge. And if your guild does not do this, there is no way that you are going to have anywhere near as big of a parse on this fight as any guild that does do this. So the only way to pump a 99 is going to be for your guild to go for this huge damage initially, and then eventually have all of the melee move in and attack the other bosses, which is Zaliak. The fear, of course, is his chain holy fire, and if you guys all run in once, it will wipe the entire raid, so you have to go in kind of as little groups. Past that, the last one I want to talk about is Gothic the Harvester, and I do think Warcraft Logs is going to change the way these logs work. It's a really buggy fight. But you can see right here, this is the fight of just Gothic itself. If you are on one side, the wrong side, the second side of the room, while Gothic comes down, he could die before the gates even open. But all of your parse includes all of the trash damage, as you can see here. The parses completely include all of the damage during phase one of this fight. So just be aware of that. Don't be sitting there AFK if you want to get a good parse or a good log on this fight. You need to do a lot of damage to all of the adds. This is a weird fight to go for a 99 on. It's kind of like the Vicidus fight, so we'll see if Warcraft Logs does a little bit of adjusting here, but it is a harder one to go for a crazy amount of damage on. And you can see the 99s are up here at 300 damage, so we're probably going to see this drop from the logs. But for now, if you want to do a good 99, if you want to get a 99 here, just focus on doing as much damage phase one, and then also on the boss. And lastly, the last one I want to mention is going to be Thaddeus, of course, for the big, big damage. And earlier I mentioned that you actually do want to use some of the Scourge set for the set bonus for this fight, but also there's a couple other things that are pretty massive on this fight. If you're a Dagger Rogue, you could have an insane parse, but only if you're lucky and aren't on the same side as the tank. So it's kind of scuffed being a Dagger Rogue. It's kind of like Lotheb. Lotheb is not nearly as good being a Dagger Rogue as being a Sword Rogue. Then as a mage, if you get the ignite as a mage, you can use a Petri Flask or get DI'd and you still maintain the ignite and can do so much damage while the rest of your mages just pretty much keep up the ignite with crits. So just be aware of that. The top parses in the world are going to be that, so that the mages don't pull aggro. Just use a Petri Flask while you have this crazy, crazy ignite. We were seeing some people doing 13,000 DPS on this fight, which was absolutely insane in one of the onslaught runs. And then as a warrior, or as every other class, I do want to mention that the parses do include the trash. So if you're killing those mini bosses, make sure that you're on one of the sides that doesn't have to hold back. Ideally, both sides have the exact same DPS, so you never have to just stop DPSing, because that just hurts you as you're not doing damage anymore. So this damage does go towards the fight. Most of your damage is still going to be Thaddeus. Probably about 90%, as you can see here, is going to be on the boss itself. But 10% of that damage is on the add. So be aware of that. And that's pretty much it, guys. That is a quick little tip breakdown for parsing in Naxxramas. Just some quick things you really need to think about and know if you're going for all of those 99s early. I will be doing really in-depth guides going over every encounter and how to parse, when to use CDs and stuff like that. But unfortunately, my internet doesn't want me to kill KT. So my bot or my guild keeps one-shotting KT and Saf, and I just lose internet each time. So it's been a very frustrating situation, as you can imagine. It is a very fun raid, guys. Good luck out there. Have fun progressing, but it is definitely a raid that early on, you can get all of these 99s like right away, and it shouldn't really be a challenge. Thank you guys for watching. Much love to everybody. I hope you are having a great, great month so far. Happy holidays to everybody, and I'll see you all on the next one.